Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to another episode of Dark Souls. And a few things happened since the last episode. Well, one thing, and then some things I'm going to take care of at the beginning of this one. First off, I bought a new crystal shield. It turns out that the guy that was in the rat sewer area, I went looking for him, and I couldn't find him, and I thought that maybe he went to the Firelink Shrine, like some of the other people did, so I spent a good while running around there until I realized that he was under the bridge thing where you go up to go to, I can't remember what that's called now, but when you go up to go to, like, the where the castle like area is, or the fortress area, and where we got, I think there was an item that used to be next to him. I think it was a ring. Probably the Ring of Sacrifice or something like that. But he's like, really hard. You have to run and jump onto it, and it's under the bridge, and then you have to walk across an inch-wide gap. But he's over there, and he does still sell the crystal shield, and apparently he also sells boss armor, because I could buy Smough's armor and the Golem's armor. But that's not the only thing I want to take care of. Another thing I want to take care of is getting rid of this curse. Now that I've finally beaten Seath. However, I don't think, it doesn't look like I get my humanity back. But, if you've played this game before, you know exactly why I am here in this area. If you haven't played this game, it's because the next door that can be opened now that I have unlocked the bonfire thing, the thing I got for beating Ornstein Smough, this door has opened now. So now I can pass through it. So now I'm no longer wasting my efforts like I was before. I'm actually continuing on to the game by killing all these golem things and Russian stacking doll creatures. And those giant minotaur demons. I am no longer simply doing nothing and not... you scared me. I didn't even know you were down there. I'm no longer just killing these guys for no reason. It's actually to advance in the game. He's coming for me. Hopefully, this isn't going to take me as many tries as it did the last time I was here. Because hopefully I can remember some of the stuff. And also, the reason I was taking damage, I found out, from holding my shield up, is because the damage shield did actually... reduce. It only protected 70% of physical damage rather than 100, like my current. And hello, worm thing, I'm running. But now, after I kill, is that guy aggro? Nope, he doesn't care. He's like, whatever, let him through. He's come this far, I've seen him before. It's about time he gets through. However, my own stupidity might stop me if I get killed by these guys. There we go. And no one's going to follow me. Now I can continue. What? Oh, the previous thing was right here, wasn't it? But now I can actually go through here and I can go down. Try Covenant. Is this going to be like a Seath thing? To where I'm going to go through that light, it's going to be an unbeatable boss. Unless I go down here and do something first. It says try Covenant, but what Covenant? There's an item over there. I might as well get that item, however I don't think there's a way back. Soul Brick, okay, not a bad item. It didn't equip it, luckily. But I don't think there's a way back now unless I walk across that route, which means which means there has to be a way to get down safely, right? Or do I have to drop? It's a giant door thing with some notes. Okay. Apparently I need to just drop down on that route. And I have a few Estus flasks. So hopefully I can do this without killing myself. There we go. Didn't take too much damage, but I wonder... I'm already down here. Might as well explore, see what's going on. Because I don't see any... Oh, enemies, except for... What the heck? They're attacking the roots. Are they gonna switch to me when all those are down? Secret. Okay, apparently they're not going to attack me. Locked by some contraption. How do I... Okay, so these things aren't going to attack me. They're just going to be weird. Because they kill all the roots. Yeah, like that. What if I kill a root? Does that do anything? Well, that's interesting, and apparently, whoever left that note there doesn't know what to do either. Do I have to kill... Oh, do I have to destroy all the roots? Is that the hint? Those bugs are giving me? Okay, I'm gonna try to destroy all the roots that I can. I can't destroy that, it's too big. And then I'm gonna go back and check the door. Okay, all the roots are... dead, still nothing. What happens when I kill all these guys? Still nothing. Ooh, what'd you drop? A sunlight medal. God, the noises. Oh, this one's on me. Okay, so they dropped... One dropped a sunlight medal, which I think you only get for... being a member of the... Covenant of the Sun, or Sunlight... Warriors, whatever it's called, and helping someone out, beating a boss, is what gives you sunlight medals. I think it improves your rank in the Covenant, if it's anything like Dark Souls 2. I think that's what happened. I think that's how the medals worked, I'm not entirely sure. But besides that giant door that, oh, I have to be part of a Covenant to open it. That's probably what that means by Tri-Covenant. But what covenant? Is it the Spider Lady? Of Chaos? What the heck? Okay, I didn't think it opened into a giant boss fight at first. But that's gonna be an AoE. Yeah. Okay, I don't do terrible damage. And okay, he has some AoE attacks I gotta watch out for. And shield. Doesn't really block against it too much. Okay, well, let's see if I can do this on the first try. It seems like all of his attacks have a... Yeah, they're all AoE. Except for that one. That one's just right down the center. You just gotta not get hit by it. Dead. Oh, I lived it. Apparently I have enough health. Okay, he's destroying roots. The roots around here, I don't know if that means anything. Gosh, that axe has so much reach. Still, if I get close to him, he's gonna use an AoE like that. I think I need to get... Oh, I rolled! How was your aim that good that you can predict the roll like that with such... Uh-oh. Such an attack that you have to charge up. Dead. Again, somehow I didn't... I'm a little confused. How am I supposed to win? If he just does that whenever I get close. And he can hit me no matter what with that little downstrike. Okay, I think the name of the game is Run Behind Him. Shoot. That didn't work so well. Yeah, his AoE attacks don't work behind him. He'll sit on me if I'm there too long. Oh, jeez. So, the get close method doesn't work with this boss. And he can predict your rolls. You can't roll out of this attack. Or I just don't know the timing yet. And I have no SS flasks. So I'm not even going to try to roll out of it. Because I'm not sure if I can. How'd that not hit? Okay, I'm behind this root. What are you going to do now, punk? Not going to use your choppy choppy. Okay, that root can't be destroyed. I'm learning very little from this encounter. I'm dead. No, I lived. Oh, how did that hit me? I was behind him. It didn't hit me when I was behind him before. Crap, now there's 19,000 souls in there. Ripe for the taking, or ripe for the losing. Okay, so I'm wearing a hodgepodge of armor and other things. Because all of this armor gives me just a bit more fire resistance. So that hopefully his fire attacks won't do as much damage to me, and I'll have a bit more time to kill him. See, like that. Barely did anything. Also, my switched my shields, because this one, it has like a 5-point bonus. Or not 5-point bonus, but it's like 5 points better at reflecting fire damage than my old shield. However, it still has 100% physical deflection, it just doesn't have as much magic and other deflection. So it can still block physical attacks really well. It's just a bit better at blocking fire damage. One more hit and he's dead. I'm going for it. Oh, 2 hits. Okay, so on a scale from 1 to 10, that was about a 4. Well, the first boss I've ever fought, Demon's Catalyst. First boss I ever fought, being the Asylum Demon, is probably a 1. Maybe a 2, since the first, not this playthrough, but the very, very first time I ever played Dark Souls, I did die to the Asylum Demon twice. So I'll give it a 2. But I think the only reason I didn't beat him the first time is because I just didn't know what I was up against. And I can actually, I can level up. But should I? Or should I forge forward and hope to find a bonfire? I'll go up a little bit. I'll go up a little bit and then down a little bit. And if I don't find a bonfire, I'll go back and level up. I'll switch, or should I switch back? Because these guys are all using fire attacks. I think that might be the new thing, is that all the things around here will be using fire attacks. Okay. These golems aren't very hard to kill, so as long as... Ooh, almost fell to my death because of targeting. Don't you do it? Don't you do it? Ooh, another soul of the brave warrior. Yeah, these golems. Okay, just making sure. Just double checking. I've been duped before. They're all moving. Has to be it. But it's moving. I can see it moving. And something tells me I should not step on that platform. I'll go back down. I'm gonna check for a bonfire downstairs. Is that what I think it is? It is. And that looks like a boss fight. Okay, so now that I have... Oh, I should probably... The whole reason I was looking for a bonfire was to level up. Didn't even do it. Let's go... As long as I'm tough to kill, I can take a lot of damage. Hopefully that can make up for my mistakes. I'm going to keep my fire resistant stuff for now. It seems like that's going to be what I need in this area. Because these guys are all spitting fire at me. Little do they know, I'm prepared. Fought their dad, the fire sage demon. There's really nothing they can do. Well, this guy's not even going to get a chance to breathe fire. So I just killed him so quickly. So I'm just that good. Then go ahead and kill these guys again. Whoops. I meant to hit both of them. My plan did not succeed. Nope. Don't you dare refire on them. Nope. Okay, now then, let's see what happens when I step on this pedestal. Whoa, it's gonna kill me, isn't it? I can't. What's going on? I'm dead. Quaylags, don't mean. Oh, it's a shortcut! How lovely. Nice. Is this a kindled bonfire? Yes. Even better. Now I can rest there and get 10 Estus flasks for the price of 5. And then I can ride this elevator to hell. That's where I came from, so... What's over here? Oh, nice staircase you got here leading to nothing. I love what you've done with the place. Is this the same staircase? Oh. Nice. There's nothing more than staircases that lead nowhere. Nothing I love more. What's that? Inconveniences, you say? Amazing. Oh, this is just to the boss area. Okay, so there's no other way to go than down. I can just kind of skip those guys, because I don't think they... You get really close to them to make them mad. They're a lot more patient than these guys. And I can make my way to the other bonfire. And I'm not going to rest at it, even if I take damage like that again, because I'd much rather respawn at the bonfire that gave me 10 Estus flasks. But I kind of want to check to see if I have enough to level up. I can warp to that other bonfire anyway, so let's see if I can level up. Yes, I can, and give myself some more health. Because the more health you have, the more of an idiot you can be, and still live to tell the tale. So I'm going to go with the be dumb, but prepared. Is the other side of the roots? Okay, so this is the other side of the hallway from wherever needs soldier. Praise the sun. You know what? I'm going to go ahead and make myself human before I go in here. Just to see if there's a summon sign. Ooh, and there's a item over here that I can grab. That I can get my hands on. Another soul of the brave warrior. I have a lot of souls stored up for when I need them. But now I can't, there's nowhere to go. Don't kill me. I hate you. Oh, I thought it made me skip that limb, and I thought that it was gonna kill me. But that's why I got more health. The more health you have, the dumber you can be. Oh, there are blood stains right there. And first I need a humanity. And my stock on humanities is 8. I have 8 humanity, or 7 now, because I used this one, and I'm probably going to lose it immediately. So now I'm human, and let's see what we have as far as summon signs go. Hopefully that thing that said needs soldier meant that there's a soldier down here I can summon. This is a player or a... Knights of Lair, my good friend. Hello. Well, we are going to head into this boss battle with Knights of Lair in the next episode, because I'm all out of time for now. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you liked this video, hit the like button, subscribe if you want to see more, and I'll see you guys next time.